So the other day I was looking at foodandwine.com, the magazine, and I realized that they published an article and they're totally wrong about something. Stay tuned and I'll tell you what. Hey everybody, this is Stuart with Wine on the Dime. So today I'm going to tell you about how Food and Wine screwed up. Now, it wasn't a huge screw up, but it was a little bit of a screw up. So the way that they screwed up is they published a great concept of an article. It was Explore Wine in 25 Wines. Fantastic idea. Here are some regions, some varietals, some things like that you need to try in order to give yourself a well-rounded kind of beginner look at wine. Great, like I said, great idea. Fantastic. Kudos to you for doing it. The thing where they screwed up were the average prices of the wine. So when I was looking at it, now you gotta keep in mind who Food and Wine's audience is. They're gonna be normally upper middle class foodies who like to travel, eat a lot of food, don't mind buying expensive bottles of wine. And as a result, their average trip around wines cost almost $1,100. As a matter of fact, it was $1,067. That is exactly how much their little trip around wines cost. If you're upper middle class and you don't mind, you don't really have a lot of worries or anything like that to worry about, you can spend your money on that, cool. I think $1,100 is way too much to spend on a tour. So what I went ahead and did is I posted my own little guide that I found using TotalWinesAndMore.com as well as Walmart. You heard me, Walmart. Only one wine from Walmart. Don't freak out, all you people who are snobs about buying stuff at Walmart. But that will give you a much better idea of what you can do, and it costs less than half of what they're looking to do, and you're still going to get a good representation of all the wines from the same regions at just less than half the price. So this is my kind of gift to you, Wine on the Dime audience. It's going to be a short video, but I just really wanted to say, don't always take what magazines and stuff like that offer at face value, because they also have a very specific clientele. For us, the people who aren't upper middle class, we have a very specific type of thing that we are interested in, which is maximizing our dollar. So in this case, I went ahead and posted that, and I believe it was like $498 or something like that as the total cost for all 25 wines, and that's including some like splurge wines that were on there. Now I will say this, in some cases they had some really good picks, so, and they were under the $15 mark, which is fantastic for them for considering them. In some cases, like the bottle they were recommending as a Cabernet from Napa was $75. My pick is $16. So anyway, this is Stuart with Wine on the Dime. If you like today's video, please like, subscribe, and comment. Check out these wines. Now, they might not always be in stock, but you might have to make some substitutes. Regardless, this is a good stepping off point. You can find some wines that are roughly around the same price point, if not the exact same wines I listed in the description below. And like I said, check out Total Wines, check out your local grocery stores, things like that, and I'm sure you'll be able to find some good representations of the region that aren't going to basically cost a mortgage. Anyway, so I will see you guys again soon with another episode. Have a good one.